everyone, welcome back to my channel. I know you may have missed me a little bit, but I've been on the road here in America. I've driven across 6 states in the past month, so if you've missed me that much, you can always follow me on Instagram. It is so much easier to stay up to date there. So hit me up if you are needing a little bit more of me in your life. So today I'm finally making one of your most requested videos, what is my camera gear? This video has been a long time coming, so please do continue to put all of your video requests down in the comments below because I will definitely get to them. In this video, I'm going to show you all of my tech and camera gear that I use to film all of my videos, my travel videos, my educational desktop videos, basically all of my gear that I use that goes into my video production. Let's get started with my backpack, the thing that carries all of this gear. So guys, I do not have any fancy equipped photography backpack. This Deuter backpacking backpack is my full-on equipment bag. My equipment can get super heavy and I'm a pretty small girl. So this backpack has all the clips and extra comfort so that it sits on my hips and I can carry the weight of all of this gear for days without it giving me back pain. Let me show you some simple features as to why a backpacking backpack works for me. So this is the backpack here. And it's unique because you can easily open the entire face here and access everything you want. So when I'm going through security at an airport, I can easily open this up, grab all of my camera gear, and then also grab my laptop from here. Call me crazy, but I prefer not to have all of these separated compartments. I like that when I open this, everything is right here and I don't have to keep unzipping multiple compartments. I keep all of my gear in their own case anyway, so they're safe from being bumped around. So on the top part, here is where I keep my blue blocker glasses, charging cables, and larger charging cables. I'll show you that in a sec. And on the inside here is where I keep my portable hard drives. On the side pocket here is where I keep my little lens cleaning kit, and then on the other side pocket here is where I keep my water bottle. This is where I keep all of my smaller charging cables and SD cards. So I keep a lot of my gear in their own separate compartments, and this is something that you can do too if you have a backpacking backpack and you don't want to drop on some really fancy photography backpack. On the front side here in this pocket is where I keep my passport and lip balm or any small makeup items if I need a quick refresher before getting my vlog cam out. And the best part about this backpack is on the bottom side here, it has a rain fly attached. And this has come in super handy, obviously, when I'm outside and it starts raining. Lastly, on the back side here is a large pouch that I keep my tripod in, and I can secure it by clipping this all in together. This backpack setup works for me, and I don't see myself getting a photography backpack anytime soon because I love this backpack so much. Okay, moving on to the most important part of this video is what kind of cameras do I use and what lenses do I use? Well, that really depends on what kind of video I'm making because sometimes I can technically use up to 5 different cameras to film it. So let's start with my first camera that I started making YouTube videos with that I still use today is my iPhone. Now I have an iPhone 8, okay? I haven't upgraded my phone in like 2.5 years because I really don't see a need to. This one works great. Obviously there have been a ton of upgrades with the camera in this phone, but I have so many cameras that I don't necessarily need to upgrade this phone because I can use all of my other cameras. So my next camera and my most used camera is the Canon G7X Mark II, which is this camera that we're looking at right now. This is the camera you are used to seeing me talking to. So all of these shots here, 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 that was all filmed from my G7X. When I'm traveling on the go, like mid-adventure, this is the camera that I keep in my pocket at all times because it's so lightweight and it's so easy for me to pull it out of my pocket when I have something to say to the camera, you know, about what I'm seeing or what I'm doing. I go into much more detail about this camera and why I love this camera so much in a video that I recently made called How I Made Over 300 Videos, and I'll link it in the description below. Go watch that video, learn more about why the G7X is my favorite filming / vlogging cam. My next filming camera that I've used in the past is the Canon M6. This is a mirrorless camera that has a better quality than the G7X, and I can control the zoom lens here. I can also purchase different lenses for this camera and attach it to this camera, and it has a little slider right here for microphone. But that is the issue with this camera. The shotgun mic goes on top. So what happens when it goes on top? You try and flip up the screen to see what you're filming, and it can't because the mic's in the way. So that's why this camera has become inconvenient, and I actually don't use this camera as much anymore. I absolutely need a screen to flip out so that I can see that I'm not like cropping my head out, or that you can see my whole body in the shot. So I do not recommend anyone get this camera if you are using it to film yourself, to make vlogs, to make videos. If you are looking to upgrade from your point and shoot and you want to go with a Canon camera, check out the M50. It is literally the exact same camera, except that the screen actually flips out this way instead of flipping up, and the microphone can still sit on top while the screen flips out. That's the M50. So unfortunately, this camera has fallen to the wayside, but I would recommend the M50 again. And honestly, that might be my next purchase for a camera. My next and most used camera is the Canon 1DX. So this camera is what I use to capture all of my beautiful B-roll that helps convey the story and move the video along. This is also what I take most of my photos with. I'm not gonna go into detail about features of this camera because I have already done so again in that video called How I Made Over 300 Videos, which please save that for later and watch. It's more about like my journey with camera equipment as a YouTuber from the beginning up until now. So this video is just basically more going in depth about also the lens that I use and my entire equipment quiver. Pack gear. One more thing I want to say about this camera, it is a very expensive camera. So I did not purchase this until it made sense for me to upgrade and until I could then afford to invest in upgrading into really high-end gear. So this is not a beginner's camera. Definitely takes a lot of getting used to, and it's quite the workout. Let's move into my lenses that I use. Along with this camera are two different sets of lenses that I use. My first lens that I purchased right after I got the 1DX is the Canon 16-35mm with an f-stop of 2.8. This is my main shooting lens on the 1DX because it has an extremely sharp, ultra wide view. The image and video quality is outstanding. It's sturdy and well built. This is overall a great lens to have because it features a range of focal lengths that I consider to be essential for full frame kit. The price tag for this lens is definitely on the expensive side. But if you are a serious photographer, then the investment in this lens is definitely worth it. With this wide angle view, especially this 16mm in this lens, it does take in a big scene with much more background showing, and that background is not as easily blurred away. Now, you would not need this lens if you were vlogging. It's unnecessary, it's a little too heavy. In terms of photography and videography, this lens is a great option, let's say if you're shooting for a wedding, an event, landscape shots. Honestly, this lens can even do pretty well with portrait style, even at the 35mm range. I've used this lens to photograph the night sky, architecture, and indoor photography because the wide angle makes the interior space look large even if the space is limited. For my videos, I need wider angles of view, so this is my primary general purpose lens. Moving on to my next lens. This lens is literally a third of my body weight. This is the Canon 100-400 telezoom lens with an f-stop of 4.5. So I originally purchased this lens because I was seeing my friend Cody's photos and videos. His YouTube channel is called Exploring with Cody. And I was like, how are you taking all of these superb photos? And he told me about this lens. So I honestly didn't even think about it. I was like, yes, I'm gonna get that lens. So this was my first telezoom lens, and I definitely needed quite a bit of time getting used to carrying this weight of this lens on top of the 1DX. But surprisingly, even though this lens does look massive, and it is massive, it is light enough to carry for an extended period of time without needing a tripod. So really had a good workout with my arms. This rotates so you can switch from landscape to portrait orientation when you are using the lens on any kind of camera support system. The zoom ring here has rubber on it, so it makes it easy to grip and move. There are a few toggle switches at the base here. The ones I use the most are the autofocus and manual focus switch, and it even has a stabilization mode that I always keep on because it does get heavy. This lens is just fantastic all the way zoomed in too. It's not a true macro lens, but it can be a pretty equal substitute. So there's just so much versatility with this lens. I have shot all kinds of photos with these lens, but my favorite shots to take are ones that show a small subject against an enormous large backdrop. And the reason why I love to take this is because you can see in these photos how well this lens compresses the smaller subject with the larger backdrop. So you can actually see the whole environment even though it's a telezoom lens. And this is a very expensive lens, but for me personally, it was definitely worth making the investment because I absolutely love this lens and I shoot with it a lot. So next up, I have two tripods. One is the Gorilla Joby Pod. It's the largest one out of all the Joby Gorilla Pods. And I got it originally for my 1DX, but I don't use it that much for my 1DX because I tend to hold that camera when I'm getting footage. And then I have this tripod. So this tripod is called Faisal CT3441S. This is made out of carbon fiber, which is the lightest material that you can get out of tripods. If you are looking to get tripods and you're on a budget, then definitely get an aluminum tripod, and then maybe later on if you want to or need to, you can upgrade and get a carbon fiber, but aluminum's pretty good. I have taken this tripod all over and it is very light. It's also very sturdy and well built. It has multiple adjustments. I can adjust the height in a variety of different ways. It has a rotating ball head right here, which makes it easy to move my camera around. So this is just a solid set of heavy duty four section legs. I've used it for landscape photography shots, and I use this when I'm shooting my educational desktop videos. So when it comes to lighting, I typically shoot in natural light. Like right now, this is all natural light, but sometimes that's limiting because the sunlight can change and then indoors can be a little dark. And when that happens, I usually have either a ring light, but since I can't really travel with a ring light, I have these Loom Cube LCD panels. I have the mini panel, which is just this much smaller, and this is the panel pro. It's a little bit bigger. So these are both full spectrum lights. Like there's 360 colors on this. It has 1 to 100% brightness adjustability, and it's easy to use with Bluetooth control. It's as small and thin as your smartphone. It is so light and compact, so easy to travel with. It does not have batteries. You just charge it with a USB-C charging cable. Next up is my drone. This is the DJI Mavic Pro. I got this in 2018 and it still works so well for me. All the drone footage you see, or most of the drone footage you see, was taken by the Mavic Pro. So I don't really see a need to upgrade. I mean, other than that, the camera quality on the newest Mavic Pros are definitely much better. Plus the whole control system has definitely upgraded, but I love this little drone and I still use it. It works great. Of course, all of my videos and photos need to be in one organized place while I'm traveling. So I keep two external hard drives with me at all times. One that I put all the footage on, and then another one for my backup, which I then back up all the footage, because losing hard drives sounds like an awful experience. It is an awful experience. This is the WD 1 TB hard drive. It has a Music Bread sticker on it from Music Bed. What I use for mostly all of my music, again, that's all the info is in the description below if you're interested in checking Music Bed out. I have one enormous hard drive that's also a WD that I keep at home. It's a 10 TB external hard drive. So whenever I go home, I dump all of this footage onto that hard drive. You gotta have all of your footage on at least two places if one of them fails. Finally, the last piece of gear that I wanna show you is these Sony Bluetooth canceling headphones. I picked up these a couple years ago, and it's one of those things that I didn't know I needed until I have them, and now I don't know what I would do without them. These help me get into the zone when I'm working. They help me relax on long flights, on long layovers, on long bus rides. These honestly just help me lock into work mode because they're noise canceling, so I don't get distracted when I'm wearing these. Okay, never mind, that was not the last piece, because I do have a bonus piece of gear, this Nintendo Switch. I got it recently, and the only game I have right now is Zelda Breath of the Wild, which is a fantastic game. So this is what I have been doing in my downtime, and I always have this with me when I'm traveling now. All right, so that is pretty much all of my tech and camera gear that I use while traveling and making videos and capturing content in general. All of these items you can find in the link in my Amazon shop in the description below. Let me know if you have any questions about any of the gear that I just talked about. And of course, as always, let me know in the comments below if you have any video requests or topics or things that you want me to cover. So thank you guys for being here. Thank you for listening and sitting down with me and listening to all my gear. And until next time, take on the world.